Well, for decades, only crackpots and crazy people believed in UFOs. That's what I thought anyway. And then in recent years, it turns out that governments have been taking them seriously all along.
There are around 1,500 aliens on the planet, most of them right here in Manhattan. And most of them are decent enough. They're just trying to make a living.
Cab drivers.
Well, not as many as you'd think. Humans, for the most part, don't have a clue. They don't want one or need one either. They're happy. They think they have a good bead on things.
Well, why the big secret? People are smart. They can handle it.
The person is smart. People are dumb, panicky, dangerous animals, and you know it. 1,500 years ago, everybody knew the Earth was the center of the universe. 500 years ago, everybody knew the Earth was flat, and 15 minutes ago, you knew that people were alone on this planet.
Imagine what you'll know tomorrow.
Very seriously. Nick Pope is a journalist who has spent years researching UFOs for the British government. He says that UFOs aren't just real. They also frequently come close to crashing into commercial airliners, among other things. Nick Pope joins us tonight. Nick, thank you very much for coming on. So it's really not a question of, do governments believe UFOs are real? Yes, they do. The United States government does. The British government does. The question is, do they have any idea what they are?
Why do you think the slave said, swing low, sweet chariot, coming forth to carry me home? You ain't talking about a slave ship. Slave ships float. But if you're asking something to swing low, it has to be flying high. So 3,000 years ago, located 700 miles south of Cairo and the Giza Plateau, at a place called Abydos, there's written on the ceiling beams of the New Kingdom Temple. Carved in stone, images of flying contraptions. Y'all can't see them from there, but you get the DVD and we'll zoom in on them for you. Here you see a picture of a helicopter. Y'all not seen it. Here you see a submarine. Here you see an airplane. Y'all with me? Then I gotta go back to the other page, because it's something that they didn't talk about. There's another object on this particular farm where you find this airplane, helicopter, and submarine. And it is an acorn-shaped object. Did y'all hear? And if you look very carefully as we zoom in, this acorn-shaped object has another smaller acorn-shaped object hovering underneath. Y'all call them UFOs. We call them IFOs. Because they are identified flying objects. These are wheels in the middle of the wheel that Ezekiel seen. This is the bomber plane and the mother plane. They seen it in Africa long before the white man ever start flying.
We got there and I took a picture facing the eastern sky with the sun rising. And I was able to pick something up. I was able to see what was to the left of the, I'm going to turn this around, the left of this. And look, we've got more things right here. More of this. And more ships. There's that little frequency thing right there also. I'm going to turn up this volume. There's that frequency thing right there. Yeah, but these ships, they're in like a different formation. They're all over the place. And there really is so many of them. And we can see that they're clearly ships. They got this black stuff on them, but I thought that was pretty neat. And what I'm showing before people, you know, some people can't zoom up that well, and this tends to be able to get you a closer view of what we're looking at up there in the skies. These things are out there, or I would not be catching them. You may not be to see them right now with our naked eye, but I'm sure we will eventually see these things, and they are on my timeline.
Sheila?
These photos, and, these are just all over there.
See, now you can see why Esau shut the observatory down, why he shut all those different webcams down, okay? This is why, okay? This is exactly why. This is how clear it was to the people that, you know, follow, that go to observatories, that look out into the heavens, you know, these different amateur astronomers and things like that, people that record what goes on into the heavens, on that's their hobby. Those are things they love to do. And this is why he shut these things down.
I think it just went by too fast. Hold on one second. Right. So, someone here seems to want to know, what about, this is kind of a question I get asked from time to time. They want to know about black aliens. You know, the color of your skin doesn't really matter when you're, you know, a different.
Where have we heard that before? The color of the skin doesn't matter. Doesn't that Maccabees ring a bell? Oh, the color of Jesus. Oh, the color of Yahawashi. It doesn't matter as long as it's the color we say he is. I guess it's just a universal concept that these Edomites get down with. Anytime it has to do with somebody black, the color doesn't matter. Mm-hmm.
Race of beings, but go ahead. Do you want to talk about the various black aliens?
Yeah, I want to tell them something that's very phenomenal. Because remember, you had Clark McCullen on your show one night.
That's
I was listening to that interview. Clark McCullen, the guy from NASA.
That's right.
The guy from NASA. He was talking about the aliens were black. And Sitchin also, I met Sitchin before he passed away. And Sitchin told me that, and there was a witness that introduced me to Sitchin with this guy, Matt Edwards from Indiana, introduced me to Zachariah Sitchin.
Yes.
And Sitchin told me that J.J. Abrams and all the big directors, I mean, he named them all. He said they all came to him trying to get his book. They wanted to do the movie, but they all wanted to make all the aliens in there white. And he said they were black. And he said that he wanted me to do, and when it came time for it to become a movie, he wanted me to do his book and be the screenwriter. And he called his grandson in and introduced me to his grandson. His grandson's name was Chris. And he told Chris, and this was several years ago before he passed away.
Right.
So for those who want to know, read Zachariah Sitchin's book, they were black aliens, and he didn't want them to be white aliens, and that's why he didn't want J.J. Abrams and all the other ones in Hollywood. They were going to change everything, and that's why he never sold his book for them to adapt to the screen.
Who's been here? Anyone? Anyone watching my house?
Uh-uh. Nobody I see.
I can't believe it wouldn't be. Kiki, I'm gonna say something that's gonna sound completely insane. But I'm telling you because I think you might actually believe me. I'm also telling you because I can't be the only one who knows in case they find me before I finish this.
Well, tell me.
You know how I followed the signal down to Mexico because we thought somebody was,
Yeah.
They weren't us, Kiki.
Well, so what was that? So do they got these little flashlight fingers that are... So maybe they got these big metal teeth that come out and sort of... Well, what does it look like then?
Like you. Like you.
Okay, but there are, if there are craft, there are beings.
Okay, people have asked me about, I call them vehicles, okay?
Right.
No, I did not call them objects. That was too neuter for me.
Okay.
I had a Stanford professor say, you ought to call them objects, Norm. No. They have all the qualities of a vehicle. Mm-hmm. They can move. You know, they're just like a missile or anything like that. So that much we can say about them, for sure.
Okay.
So I'm calling them a vehicle.
Okay.
Okay, somebody comes along and says, well, now, where would you manufacture one that's 2.5 Earth lengths long? And that's a hard question to answer.
So are you not positing the idea that those vehicles contain, you know, beings who are, you know, maybe like us?
Yeah, I only go along with garment images. And if you want to know about people kind of thing, there is the ship that picked up the Voyager capsule at the Alameda Naval Shipyard, and they have a picture there of I think it's the Apollo flight that Bugs and Neil were on. But anyway, there is one image there that shows black people getting off. There is one image there that shows black people getting off.
So people with dark skin getting off.
Not dark, black.
Black skin.
Really black. Yeah.
Were they tall?
Yes.
Very tall?
Yeah.
How tall? Do you know?
Well, they got out the doorway. I don't know how high that is, but...
Well, what...
Say 7 feet would be probably a conservative estimate.
Like me, like anyone.
Then what they doing here?
I'll show you. I'll show everyone as soon as I fire up the array.
Tell them, you go back and tell them that I know, that she knows, that others will know. It's not going to be easy. Not anymore.
Police and the fire departments are asking
it is morning. You wake up.
Hey, come on.
You greet your loved ones. You grab the morning paper. And although it seems like any ordinary day, it isn't. For one extraordinary reason. For one extraordinary reason.
Unprecedented event is occurring. The question of whether or not we are alone in the universe has been answered.
This is so cool.
More ships have just arrived over India, England, and Germany.
I really don't think they flew 90 billion light years to come down here and start a fight.
We've got to stop them! They're going to kill us all! We've got to stop them! They're going to kill us all!
Hey, what's up, guys? I just wanted to share this dream I had last night. Today's January 2nd, 2017. And I don't know why I would have this dream. It was random. I never had it before. And I just felt like it was strange and I wanted to share it with you guys. But I pulled up to this grocery store parking lot and I get out of my car and I see people, you know, in a panic, looking up, pointing, and I look up and there was this huge, like, horseshoe shaped craft hovering above us, like, real slowly. And on top of the craft, I noticed it had, like, these buildings, like skyscraper buildings and statues that were also very, like, large, like skyscraper size. And the craft was huge, like a city size aircraft. But yeah, and then I see it fly by us and then it drops two bombs in different parts of the city. And that's when people, you know, and I start feeling panic in the dream and we start running and I'm trying to figure out how to get out of the city and find my family and get us, you know, somewhere safe. And I noticed that there's this like lava substance that's flowing, like swallowing things and people, like going uphill and going up buildings, and it felt like you couldn't escape from it, like no matter where you went. But then I find myself with friends and family, and that we were trying to, you know, figure out what we could do. And that's when the beams from the craft appeared to us. And what tripped me out is that they were all black people. Holy padlock.
For one extraordinary reason.
There is one image there in that shows black people they are.
Like you.
And they said that we had to come with them if we wanted to survive or to live. But then they said that no white people were allowed to go with them, that they had to stay here. And then I asked them why, and they said because your leader has broken our treaty, and for that they had to be punished and they couldn't be trusted anymore or something like that. And then I tell him, but you know, my kids are half white. And he tells me, you know, that was fine, that to bring them. And so I'm right there, I guess, walking down the street behind them, like towards, I guess, the craft. And I see people on the sides of the streets, like, yelling, you know, don't go, don't do it, it's a trap, it's better for you to stay and fight, and things like that. And I kind of started thinking, like, you know, yeah, what is it that these people want? What are they going to do to me and my kids? Where are they taking us? And as I'm thinking that, one of the guys or whatever from the craft, he turns around and, like, kind of looks at me. And the strange thing is like, he was showing me, like, glimpses through, like, the mind's eye of their home. So I'm, you know, I was right there just staring at him, and it almost felt like he was just showing me pictures in my mind of what their home looked like and what it was like. And, you know, as I'm sitting or standing there thinking, what should I do? It feels better for me to go or to stay and fight. That's like when I wake up. But yeah, I just thought it was strange, and I just wanted to share that with you guys. And, you know, I woke up, like, tripping out. Almost felt like if it was some type of message, dream. And I still, you know, could picture it pretty, like, vividly, the craft and their home planet. And so I started Google searching, like, horseshoe-shaped UFOs. And I found some, but I could, you know, there was no picture of the exact one that I seen in my dream. And I also started looking for videos of them, like, I guess if there ever is, you know, was a record of any extraterrestrials that were actually, you know, like, black people. And there was videos I came across about that subject, and of I forgot the name of this guy, but some, like, NASA scientist guy or astronaut or something like that, just, like, telling his story and how he also seen these black extraterrestrial beings once. And I thought it was interesting, so I just wanted to share that with you guys. You know, if you have any comments or tell me what you guys think, I'd like to hear it. Or if you've had any, like, similar type of dreams. But all right, man, peace out.
Where they're from. No, we don't. We keep an open mind on it. We don't rule anything off, you know, take nothing off the table with this. Our point really is that whatever these things turn out to be, there is a serious defense, national security, and air safety issue here.
Yes.
Well, so that's kind of the nub
of it, and that's where my interest comes from. So why aren't governments encouraging the population to, as they say about terrorism, if you see something, say something, report sightings to the government so we can make sense of this potential threat?
Well, they should be, and that's what we certainly did at the Ministry of Defense for many years. We took it very seriously. Our own pilots were seeing these things. We were having radar operators track them. And we knew, again, through intelligence and through open source material, we knew that the Russians and the Chinese and others were working on this too. The problem was that just the pop culture baggage from the term UFO, flying saucer, little green men, people don't take it seriously. But they should. Right. Don't take it seriously, but they should.
The hieroglyphics tell us the story of two visionaries, outcast, not of this world. They led a band of ragtag followers carrying everything they had, pursued by forces of evil. The symbols show us they reached their destination, but what happened inside is a mystery.
They don't want black people to know that they have extraterrestrial ancestry.
Now that's a conference. This is a conference. All white people in there. Ain't no niggas in this conference. Somebody just happened to be recording with their phone. This is David Wilcock. What did he just say? Let me play it back. He said they don't want black people to know that they have extraterrestrial DNA. Now, before I play this and show other things, I just want to say this. I've been saying this shit for 5 years. So the shit you niggas is just now trying to jump on and white people just now admitting certain things, I've been fucking saying this. So some of y'all don't listen to facts when it come from a black man. So a white person has to say the same shit I'm saying, okay? Just like I had to play yesterday the video of the white man saying he was a Neanderthal hybrid, now I have to play a video of a white man saying that the elites are withholding certain information from the general public because they don't want black people to know they have extraterrestrial DNA. Because you niggas don't listen when it come from somebody that look like me. So I have to have a white man tell you the truth because that's the only person that y'all listen to appearing. So let me let this white man tell you the same shit I've been trying to tell you for damn near 5 years now. Here we go.
They don't want black people to know that they have extraterrestrial ancestry.
Right, and you were being told that black people didn't serve.
Didn't serve in the space program.
Right. And there were people from all races.
Right. Very interesting.
So, boom. You heard that, right? Now I'm not done. Now watch this. I'm not done. Where is my shit? Hold on. Let me make this a little bigger so I can see. Where is my shit? Here we go. Now look. 145 alien genes. Huh? Scientists discover this is not from our ancestors. Now, y'all gotta read between the lines. Because remember, they say only real human beings is black people. They say if you're not black, then you only 93% human, 7% Neanderthal. It might be more than that. Okay? Now, I'm going to just go through this quick. I'm not going to go in detail. I'm just giving y'all where I'm going. You want the details, go to my website. Look at that. 147 alien genes. Look at this. Humans contain alien genes not passed from our ancestors, researchers have discovered. Who is humans? Now, look at this. Talking about the O negative blood type, huh? Which is an extraterrestrial blood type. Look at this, huh? Africans, huh? Unknown human DNA species. I put this out years ago. This shit just came out this year, February 14, 2020. Scientists firing ghost lineage of DNA in the African. See? Now let me explain something to you. Okay, I'm not gonna go into details on the article. Let me explain something to you. If they never found no anthropological bones, they never found no leftovers or no bodies, huh? Where did these motherfuckers go? If black women have an entire human species in their DNA that accounts for an entire civilization or race of people, and nobody never seen these motherfuckers, we must ask ourselves, did they even die? Where did they go? Is they under the water? Is they outer space? Where did they go? See, now you might say, Pharaoh, what is a metagene? See, now what you're looking at is the template for our amino acids. Now, amino acids are like Legos, and you can construct Legos differently to create different pieces. And so why is this important? We have 64 amino acids. You only got 20 to 22 active. And so when you watch the movie X-Men, you're an X-Man and you become a mutant. One of your genes mutate and activate and give you psychic abilities. The fucking CIA already admitted psychic abilities are real. So I don't think I need to argue that with y'all. Okay? They already admitted this shit is real. Now, why is this important? All of these other genes that you see on this chart are not even yet unlocked or available to you. So this is why black people are being organ harvested. This is why black people are having our placenta stole. This is why Planned Parenthood, which was set up by the Ku Klux Klan, yes it was, okay, is stealing our fetuses and using our tissues for their own scientific evil experimental endeavors. So the red box that you see is the only amount of your proteins in your DNA that you use in this lifetime. So you don't know what the fuck you capable of, black man and black woman. Because you have not yet reached your full human potential. But how you gonna reach your full human potential eating this fucking processed food, living underneath this poisoned ass air? Why you think they poison the air, poison the water, poison your motherfucking mind? So that you do not unlock your metagenes. Go research metagenes. Metagenes, meta means beyond, okay? Excuse me, I spoke the damn word wrong. Let me fix it. Meta means beyond, okay? So a metagene is a gene beyond normal expression, okay? Black people have genes that take us beyond normal human level of existence. Huh? So if you think these niggas that's running this basketball up a court, these niggas that's throwing this football up a field, if you think those is some genetically advanced niggas, them niggas ain't even tapped into one of these motherfucking amino acids, let alone all of them. Huh? 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 They call them mythomolecules. See, your DNA actually is coiled up and it unravels via exposure to light. Huh? This is why they got a roof on every goddamn thing. Your house, your car, everything. It takes 8 minutes for you to get fresh sunlight. You're not even outside for it. I already broke this down in the other video. I'm not going through this again. See? So you will not reach your full human potential living underneath a motherfucker that can't even live in the sun. Our DNA is unlocked by the sun. These people are killed by the sun. So how can they give you a blueprint for you to reach your full motherfucking potential, and the thing that unlocks your greatness destroys them? Look at this. Look at this. Because they're going to say I'm cat. They're going to say I'm being racist. They're going to say I'm being racist. Let me give my disclaimer for all my white people watching. I love you to death. This is not this is education. Don't be mad at me. Be mad at your people for lying. We both got to come into the truth. God damn it. Let me show you something, though. Let me show you something with the facts. Let me hit you niggas with the facts. Wait a minute. Let me hit you niggas with the facts. Where they go? Where they go? Look, look, skincancer.org. You see this? You see this? Two white people die every hour from motherfucking skin cancer caused by the sun. Nobody making this up. Look at this. Israel. The second, Israel's skin cancer rate is the second highest in the world.